Hello everyone, my name is Ashmit Umal and I'm here to tell you about how to use Zolo V5 to detect objects from video and images with Flask at the front end to upload the files. So let's get started. As you are visible with my screen, we have a aim to detect objects in video images through Zolo V5 model with Flask at the front end to upload the files. So what are the requirements for this project? First of all, we will be requiring Python, Flask, which is a microservice framework, and the Zolo V5 models and some of our debugging skills. So let's move to the resources. So what is Python? As everyone knows, Python is a language for using for codes, for many of the code. So here you can download the Python, and if you are not already downloaded it. Next is our Zolo V5 model. There are many Zolo models starting from the version 1. Zolo stands for you only look once. So it's the version 5 of the Zolo model, which is in Zolo in the PyTorch repository. So they have a GitHub repository where they tell about how to use this model, but this model is only about command line and they only shows about how to detect with images. There are no ways to know how to detect from the videos. So I'm here to use the Flask at the front end so that the user can upload the video from the front end, and then the code is sent to this model. Here we process the video and then the result is shown to the front end, which user can download. So here I have used all the code. As you can see, first of all, there is so many of code, which there are so many files which are not user friendly to understand for all of you. For that I have used the important code that will be required for us, and also added the Flask code for us. So where is the code? So our code will be here. I have installed the link and I will also send you in the video description. So here is my repository, Zolo V5 with Flask. So try to clone this repository and then we will start the coding. If anyone don't know how to clone the repository, just open your command line. Here you should have Git installed. You just type git clone and then paste this link. And this will install all of the files that are pasted here. This repository is about 100 MB as I have the model weights here, which is quite big file. Okay, so after the installing you will have this code on your computer. So let's look at this code one by one. So what are the files that are required by us that will help us? So first is this detect.py. this is a Python file that was written in the original PyTorch library. Here they have used the weight source and the image size and their other hyperparameters that are sets. So with this detect.py, we detect the images and videos and then send back to the with the help of Flask. So everyone knows what is Flask. If not, let me show you. So Flask is a microservice framework which is written in Python. It has no data abstraction layer form validation, but it is quite good as it is very fast and easy to use. I haven't mentioned the installation, but you can install the with this installation document, you can easily install this Flask. So let's get started to our code. So here some files are of Python and some of our files of our Flask code. So this app.py is our Flask code which I have written for us. So basically it has three roots. One is the home roots, which render the index.html page, which I will show you once. And then I have a detect root, which will, when image will be sent to this method, we will save the image. Then we will run this detect.py code and then it will return our the file. With this return file tag, this was not used I think in the our code, but let's say what you do. First open your command line or terminal if you are using a Python. Just type flask run. Your code repository will started running. So let's go to our code. So this is our object detection Zolo, which have a user input field. I haven't made so much of template. You can also do if you want, but here is a fully functional. So I haven't used any template or UI. So how to use this? This index.html is served from this file, which is a template here, index.html. I have used the normal simple tag and there is a input file and there is a button send button. Okay. We have a static files such as CSS and JS here. This is the formal or official type of data folder structure that we use in Flask. We have one app.py in the root level, then we have static and template file as a other folders in our Flask code. So After running Flask code, it just takes the index.js and index.js from our static folder and served it our React. So how it is used? We just use the choose file. When our choose file, let's try with this image1. No, it's already done. Let's try different one. Okay. So here is our image. I have shown the image, and when we send the image, you can see here our code is started running. Just a minute, you will see our code. It will load all our datas and then it will show. Okay, it takes time but it's done. Okay, our folder is saved and the result is saved in our static folder here. And then there is a download button which was not appeared before. I have used the jQuery, you can see his here, index.js. Whenever our request is sent and we have a success message, I just make the visibility of this link component as a visible and add a download attribute with a href here. So when you click on download, you can easily download the image. And after downloading the image, if you view, oh wow, I got the object detection. But this is just photo. I have also told about I can use this with video. So how to use with video? It is also simple, there is nothing difference. You just upload the video this time, but video takes time to process. Let's try this video, video1.mp4. Okay, I tried the video1.mp4. I click on send and here our data started running again. Oh, this video has 265 frames, so it will take time. Let's make this happen. Till then, I think I have made the everything code understandable to you. If not, let me use the size bigger. Okay, it's become too big. I think our code is visible. Let me tell you once again. Here's our app.py. This is a Flask code. As you can see, I have imported a Flask. I have one root, here the main root, which only renders the index.html. This is a detect endpoint, which have a post method in which we send our video. After the video send, we just save the video and we just run the Python command to detect.py, this file, which detects our image, process the image and then output it. Here, I have just returned the object. And when this object is returned, where is this object is returned? Here. Here you can see index.js. Here in our success.method, this output is returned. We just console log and then send the link visibility to 1. And then we have make the download ID of download to this link, which is static.data, which links to over this image. So when you click on this front end download button, this file gets downloaded. Let's see if a file gets downloaded. Okay, it's completed. So let's see if we can download it or not. Okay, we got video.mp4. Let's try to play it, hope for the best. Oh wow, it's working. It has detected person, it has detected skis, what not. Oh wow, backpack also, that's cool. Okay, that was all. If you have any doubt, you can always ping me on in LinkedIn. I will share the link. You can see me on LinkedIn as Asmith Vimal or as GitHub in VI Asmith. I will paste all the links and necessary resources to this video link. Hope you like the video and I will try my best to make another if I get the good subscription from all of you. Thank you and have a great day.